Welcome to another video on data analysis made easy in R using Rattle. And today we're going to look at data preprocessing. The objective of creating an accurate model requires the data quality to be improved. And this is where data transformation comes in. But in order to transform your data, you need to understand it first. So in real life, you can explore and transform iteratively until you're happy with your data. And you'll find that data scientists can spend up to 80% of the analysis time preparing data before they start modeling. And that's because data quality affects model performance. So with Rattle, transformation of a variable won't modify the original variable. What Rattle does, it creates a new variable and it adds a prefix that indicates that the performed transformation and the name of the original variable. And we're going to have a look at that in just a moment. So I've already started up R, and what we're going to do is we need to start up Rattle. And now we need to run the Rattle function, and that will start Rattle up. And here we have Rattle. So the first thing we need to do is to upload our data. In the description below, you'll find a link to the data that I'm using. It's a CSV file. It's by the name of test. And it's just to test out the transformation functions that Rattle offers. So the first thing we need to do is to find or to upload our data. And in my case, I've got it on. This is test data that we need. Once you've selected your data, you must always click on execute. And we can see here that these are the variables, and it tells us the variable types here. This is the target variable that's automatically been chosen by Rattle for our prediction. Although we can change it, we don't have to have this. And we can notice here that location has been marked as ignore. And once again, we can change that. And under the comments, we can see some interesting information. It tells us how many values are missing. On the transform tab, we can then find all the different operations that Rattle can do in helping us to clean our data. So we're going to start off with selecting the clean up radio button. And this gives us a number of options. So the first one is delete ignored. So the variables here that we've marked as ignore from transform, delete ignored, this will delete that variable. So what I will do is I'll click execute, and this window has popped up and it tells us that it will delete the variable which is in the memory. The data set is in memory, so it'll delete it from the memory, but the original data will not be affected. So the data that's on the system will not be affected. So we'll click yes, we want that to happen. And we can see that it's disappeared from here, and from here as well, it's disappeared. Next we have delete selected. And this will delete the selected variable. So for example, if we wanted to delete date, just select that and click execute, and once again a warning will come up telling us that the memory data set, this variable will be deleted from there but not from the original data. And we can see now that that has been deleted. Next we got two options. We got delete missing and delete observations with missing. There's a slight difference between them. Delete missing, this will delete all the variables with the missing data. Any variable that has missing data will be deleted. What I'm going to do is click execute, and this comes up and it tells us that max temp, sunshine, wind gust direction, wind gust speed, and wind speed, these variables will be deleted because they have missing values. I'm going to click no for the time being. This brings us to delete observations with missing, and this is different. Here, only the observations that are missing, they will be deleted. The variables will remain, only the missing values will be deleted. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click execute, and we have our information window come up, and this tells us a different story. It tells us that 338 entities will be deleted. So the variables will remain, only their missing values will be deleted. So what I'll do is I'll click yes, and we'll see all the variables will still be there, but there'll be no missing values. And we can see here that there are no missing values, but we have all the variables. What I'll do is I'll reload the data again, and then we'll have a look at this delete missing. So let's have a look at what delete missing will do. This will delete all the variables. Any variable that has missing data, it will delete it. So we can see here we've got 14 variables. I've selected delete missing. Click execute. Warning has come up that all these variables will be deleted. So we'll click yes. And we can see that from 14, we've gone down to 9 variables. So any variable that had a missing value, that's been deleted. Some algorithms, like clustering models, they only work with numeric variables. And so there's a simple technique that will convert a categorical variable into numerical variables, and that's indicator variables. So as an example, if we have this data here, which you can download from the description, it's called catdata.csv. We'd like to create a clustering model using this data. However, the problem we have here is that we've got categorical variables here for the level, and we need to convert them into numeric variables. And the way we're going to do this is by using indicator variables. And what will happen is that beginner, medium, and advanced will be changed into 3 new variables. If the value of level is beginner, the set variable beginner will be changed to indicate 1, and the others will be changed to 0. And we're going to have a look at what I mean by this once we've done the transformation in Rattle. Now, I've already uploaded the data, which we can see here. So this is our level. It's got just 3 unique values, and we've got 10 observation values. We just need to go to transform, recode, indicator variable. We can see here that for level, we have 3 categorical variables. We will select that, and we will click execute, and 3 new variables have been created. And to indicate that these are new variables that have been created by Rattle, we have this TIN prefix in front of the variables that have been changed to indicator variables. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to save the data, and then we can open it up to see what Rattle has done to the data. To save data, you just need to click on the export button, and it shows us that a prefix has been attached to the data sample, and it's showing us where this will be saved, this file. If you need to save it in a particular location, you can then select. So I will click save. So this is the saved data. We've still got our observations, which are numerical. We have our levels, which are categorical, and here we have our indicator variables. So this first column is for advanced, the next column is for beginner, and the last column is for medium. For beginner, we can see advanced is set to 0, beginner has 1, and medium is set to 0. And in the same way, for advanced is set to 1, beginner is set to 0, and medium is set to 0. And for medium, advanced is set to 0, beginner is set to 0, and medium is set to 1. Rattle also has a number of other options. So here we've got the rescale option. With rescale, normalize, or you can order the variables. What this means is that if you were to normalize the variables, it means you'd modify the variables so the different observations will fit into a scale. The most common normalization scale is 0 to 1. In addition to 0 and 1, you've got this median, natural log, log 10, and matrix options as well. For order transformations, you only have two options, rank and interval. With the rank option, Rattle converts variables. It'll convert the variable values to a rank, assigning one to the minimum value of the variable. This can be quite useful if you're interested in relative positions of a value in a distribution rather than the real value. If you choose the interval option, interval groups the values into different groups. The impute option, this is used to deal with missing values, and here you have a number of options. With zero or missing, using this option, Rattle will replace all the missing values in a numeric variable with zero, and if it's a categorical variable, it'll replace it with missing. The mean option is used to fill in missing values only in numeric variables. And obviously you can't use this with categorical variables. With the median option, once again, you replace the missing values with the median value, same as the mean option, and this can only be used with numeric variables. With the mode option, this will replace missing values with the modal value, and once again, you can only do this with numeric variables and not categorical variables. With the constant option, this allows you to enter a constant value and replace the missing value with. The final thing that we're going to look at is partitioning of data. In machine learning and other model building techniques, normally you would partition your data set into three parts: training, validation, and testing. The training data you would use to fit the model. The validation data, this you would use for model selection. And so this data would be used to select the model from among candidates by balancing off the trade-off between model complexity, which will fit the training data well, and generality, which might not fit the validation data. So this data, the validation data, potentially is used several times to build the final model. And the test data, this is a holdout sample that you will have to assess the final model and estimate its prediction error. And this is only used at the end of the model building process. So to do this, I've already loaded up the test data. You need to make sure that the partition tick box is selected. And in here, I've already put in some numbers, 70, 15, and 15. And if you add these numbers up together, that will give you exactly 100 or 100%. So what are these numbers? The first number, 17, this is the percentage of data that will be used for training. The second number, 15, this is the percentage of data that you will use. The second number, 15, is the percentage of data that we'll use for testing. And the last number, the last 15% of data, that'll be used for validating. You can have any percentage for the training, testing, and validating, but just make sure that it just adds up to 100%. Now, usually you'll find that in most situations, the data is really split into training and testing only. The data is drawn randomly. This random drawing of data depends upon a seed number. Using a seed number allows you to reproduce the selected data. And for the seed number, once again, you can choose any number that you prefer. Now, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask by putting in a comment, and I'll do my best to answer it. And if you found this video useful, then please click on the subscribe button. And thank you for joining me. Until next time.